The first question is, we have a slight problem of racial cultural segregation among the South Florida Muslims. The problem is much bigger at the level of the leadership of Islamic institutions. What have other communities done to address these problems? Also, masjids and organizations and schools do not work together often as they're supposed to. So this is the question related to the problems we have here in this community.
The question was about what did other communities do about ethnic divides and ethnic barriers and ethnic mosques and ethnic schools. They are very much at various stages of dealing with this problem. In Houston, about 17, 18 years ago, I used to live there and we refused. We had only one center at that time. And as a community, as a collective effort, we refuse to establish a mosque that is separate from the main center. Currently, Houston has more than 7-8 mosques, all of them connected with the headquarters, Islamic Society of Greater Houston, and none of them is ethnically divided or ethnically centered. And they also do have about 4 schools that are not ethnically divided and ethnically separated. Yeah, but the 9 of them are connected with the main center. I don't know about the rest. Okay, Brother Yahya is saying they became 13 Islamic center. In any case, this is what one community did. The other example that is going on in New York, coordination between 40 out of 100 imam available, I believe is also worth considering, whereby I always believe in gradual approach. People are full of fears. People are full of phobias against each other. People are full of misinformation. As much as we bash the media for stereotyping us, do you know what? When they forget us, we bash each other, and we do it effectively, because we're close to each other. We know how to bash it effectively. They do it on the surface. So we need to stop the bashing. Whenever, this is your first step, whenever you hear something that falls within the issue of stereotyping, stop it. Don't listen to it. This is where you start. And start promoting what is good about everybody else, instead of just saying, I am the good and everybody else falls behind. That is basically what I suggest. The other thing is, there are things that we can do and they don't really need really very much, which is coordinate the Eid prayer. You know, this is a big gathering. It's once a year or twice a year. Many people will say, but we don't even know when the Hilal comes and everything. Brothers and sisters, agree to the methodology by which you determine. Let us say that the leaders in this area will meet and say, this year we are going with, and then name it. We're going with ISNA, we're going to see our own Hilal, form one committee to determine that for us, but go all together in one direction. Once you agree to the method, the outcome will be unifying for everybody. But if we disagree on the method, then no matter what the outcome is, nobody will agree, nobody will accept. So please, do what is doable. Agree to Ramadan, the beginning and the end. Agree to make one or two big, great Eid prayer. Agree to do the biggest festivities ever in this area for Muslims. Invite all the media, get all the kids, get all the youth. Do you know what? If you want unity, let the youth lead you. They don't have our phobia. They don't have our barriers.
We are kind of running out of time. Unfortunately, the discussion is very fruitful and we're all enjoying it. But we have to leave in a few minutes, so I'd like to, from the speakers, to be a little bit more precise and more. So, Brother Sal, you have.